Wow.
I'm very glad that I can be here again.
Makanya
to be,
belum tahu.
To be with everyone here. You know, I only see all of you on Sunday, so I appreciate Sundays a lot. Okay, let's prepare our heart today. Mari kita buka dengan ucapan syukur kita sama Tuhan untuk segala yang Tuhan sudah berikan. Bapa, kami mengucap syukur Tuhan for everything that you have given, Lord Jesus. For you have walked with us, for you have guided us, for you are always in front of us, behind us, around us, Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you that you've never left us nor forsaken us. We thank you that in times of hardship, you are there. In times of happiness and joy, you are there, Lord Jesus. And Father, we thank you for all our families and friends, for our parents, for our siblings, everyone, Lord Jesus. We thank you that we can be here today to worship you, to give you thanks and praise. Father, today we ask for your presence, Lord Jesus, to not just linger, but also come into our heart, Lord Jesus. We invite the presence of God into our heart, into our lives. Father, we want to dedicate this little time of ours to just experience, you in this place, Lord Jesus. Father, we ask that Holy Spirit work in this place from the very start to the very end. We pray for our friends that are on their way, that they may arrive here safe and sound. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We are ready to worship you. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Mari kita angkat lagu ini ya. Kita ucapkan terima kasih. Thank you.
Oh, Thank you.
because what is me? We've all here experienced God's love. Amen. We've all here experienced God's grace. I can speak for myself that grace is the foundation of my life. Since I found God, since I know God, grace is there to walk with me. You know, the grace of God that is carrying me through the hard time, the joyful time, so that we all will be still, you know, we all still have relationship with God. That is His grace. Mari kita nyanyikan lagu ini. Kita mau katakan kasih Tuhan itu tiada batasnya. God's love has no end.
Thank you. is for you, if God is with you, who can be against you? God will bless you. God will protect you. God will keep His eye upon you. God will make you victorious in every situation in your life. God will give you good health. God will give you good understanding of your life. God will give you a strong heart. God will give you a strong mind, and you will be blessed in your life. In the name of Jesus, go and learn the Word of God today and be blessed. Thank you, Lord. Amen. You may see it. Oh, now I see. Saudara yang kekasih, hari ini kita akan belajar mengenal satu jaminan untuk hidup kita, perkemenangan. Firman Tuhan berkata, Roma 8 ayat 32, 31 dan 32, jika Allah di pihak kita, siapakah yang akan melawan kita? If God is for us, who can be against us? Ia yang tidak menyayangkan anaknya sendiri, tetapi yang menyerahkannya bagi kita semua. Bagaimanakah mungkin ia tidak mengaruniakan segala sesuatu kepada kita bersama-sama dengan dia? Jadi firman ini bertanya, kalau Tuhan itu di pihak kita, siapa yang bisa melawan kita? Tuhan yang, iya, Tuhan yang sudah tidak menyayangkan anaknya, artinya dia dengan sukarela memberikan anaknya sendiri dan menyerahkannya untuk kita supaya kita diselamatkan. Bagaimana mungkin ia tidak mengaruniakan segala sesuatu kepada kita bersama dengan dia? Allah di pihak kita, siapa yang bisa menang tentang terhadap kita? Kalau Tuhan sendiri yang bermurah hati sudah memberikan anaknya yang begitu mahal harganya, anak kekasihnya sendiri, masakan, kalau kata Indonesia, masa sih? Dia tidak berikan juga yang lain-lainnya, yang segala keperluan kita, kebutuhan kita setiap hari. Bagaimana mungkin ia tidak mengaruniakan? Kalau kita bisa pikirkan, ada orang yang satu hari memberikan kepada saudara satu rumah yang indah, penuh dengan baik, rumah bentuknya bagus, yang mahal harganya, yang millions barangkali, dan ada orang yang begitu murah hati memberikan rumah itu kepada saudara, masakan, segala perabot-perabotnya nggak dikasih,